Dude.
Oh yeah, Motown baby, that's what I'm talking about. I loved it. I'm happy about it. I hope they liked it. I think so.
Welcome back to American Idol's tribute to the music of Motown. Quick shout out to Brad Whitford, guitarist from Aerosmith, who is in the house tonight. There you go. There you go. Next on our stage is our youngest contestant. It is Thea.
Last week was a bit of a tough week for me.
You've been singing all these ballads every week. For me, this was very boring. Maybe a different kind of song next time.
I do agree with Randy on that, which is why I chose Heatwave by Martha and the Vandellas.
Heatwave!
Come down quicker.
This is my time to actually showcase my up-tempo side of me. Heatwave was written in 1963, and it was based off of a piano warm-up.
How are you?
How are you feeling about this?
Awesome.
When I heard about you singing this song, I'm like, okay, here she goes. The judges wanted an up-tempo record. Well, they got it.
I think Heatwave is the right record. Tricky and Kook are the right producers. They're some of the best vocal producers in the world.
Did you pull that off loud?
Yeah, absolutely.
And she had nothing but confidence in that room, and she sang it great.
I'm pleasantly shocked. Okay. What you gotta do now is just take it from this studio and carry it to the show.
I guess I knocked it out of the park with Jimmy, and I'm hoping that I'll be doing the same on stage tonight.
All right, we're about to find out. Here's Heatwave from 16-year-old Thea Mejia. Go get him.
A little bit with you right there. It was great to see you let loose like that. Wow, who knew you had that in you? I didn't, and I wasn't sure. But now that we're going there, now I need you to dig even deeper each week. You know, you're 15, 16 years old. 16, 15?
16.
You're 16 now, okay. And, you know, I don't expect you to have all the life experience in the world to bring what you need to bring to the lyrics, but part of performing is acting, and you have to bring that every time. So always make sure you connect with your lyrics so you can bring even more, because I just see, now I know you got it in you.
Thank you,
Yo. Listen, well, the reason you're here is because we knew you had it in you, right? And the public is definitely resounded with that because you've been here every week. So,
but
this new thing is a good thing, because I know I've been a little tough on you the last couple of weeks. But I gotta say, it's about taking chances. You took a chance tonight. You didn't sing a really safe ballad. Although I still feel you can, Jennifer's right, you can dig deeper and you can do more with it, take more vocal chances. You can really sing. I just want you to believe, and I'm happy to see you move up a notch tonight with something different. Congrats on that. Take some chances. Continue. Push.
Push, push.
Yeah, I agree with what Jennifer was saying and Randy. You know, you've taken a step out. I love it. Just great. I'm good. I'm good with it. Yeah.
Good job. Congratulations. Did it feel comfortable having fun with it, loosening up a little bit?
I did. I mean, I felt great just having the opportunity to loosen up to you guys, you know, so I had so much fun. Thank you.
If you want to vote for Thea, 1-866-IDOLS-02. That's 1-866-436-5702. Or text the word vote to 5702. You'll have at least 2 hours to vote, but not until the end of the show. Thank you, Thea.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it, darling.
Thank you.
We're gonna take a break, but on the other side, Lusk and Lauren try to lure you in. More Idol Live next. Hang on.
I thought there was a little bit, but hopefully nobody noticed. You know, but I still had an awesome time up there.
From the epicenter of all things entertainment. And up next on the Idol stage is our former spa concierge, Jacob.
Motown is soul. This week, I am singing the 1968 Motown classic, You're All I Need to Get By, by Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell.
There's no one in the competition more natural to sing Motown than Jacob.
The guys that wrote these songs, right, and sang them, right, come from the same place you're coming from. They came from a gospel background, so this would be a very good fit for you.
I do have a church background. I grew up in church all my life. I sing songs that have meaning. For me, I can't just sing a song that's just a fun song. No, can't do that. I have to sing songs that when you hear them, it's gonna affect a change in you. Motown music was about that.
Cause we got the right foundation, yeah.
What I was concerned about with Jacob is that it's an incredible fireworks show when he sings. But you see it week in, week out, a lot of licks, a lot of runs. It loses its specialness. So I wanted him to grab the song and sing it and control it and use that power when it's justified in the song. When I finally got to the studio and heard Jacob sing, I felt a restraint that I hadn't felt from him before.
I definitely feel that I may be hitting the high notes too much. And I kind of need to really relax off of it a little bit. It's just, it's been so crazy that when you get out there and you can't hear yourself, you just kind of just go for it.
If he gets nervous up there and puts his foot on the gas too early, I think he's gonna miss an opportunity to really show people what he can do.
It's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's a good one.
Joining Jacob on stage tonight is one of the original Funk Brothers, Bob Babbitt. His performance is honoring the late, great James Jamerson. With your All I Need to Get By, it is Jacob Lusk.
Like a sweet morning dew, I took one look at you, and it was plain to see that you were my destiny. With my arms open wide, threw away my pride. I'll sacrifice for you, dedicate my life to you. I will go where you lead, always there in time of need. And when I lose my will, you'll be right there to push me up the hill.
There's no looking back for us. We got a love and show love that's enough. You're all I need.
Like an eagle protects his nest. For you, I'm gonna do my best. Stand tall like a tree. I dare anybody to try to move me. Just to do what's good for you and inspire you a little higher. I know you can make a man out of a soul that didn't have to go.
Cause we
Amy Luther. The great Berry Gordy is somewhere saying, oh my God. Jacob, listen. This is your other best performance on this entire stage in this entire history of the show. Why? You took your time in the verse. It's just what Jimmy said. You worried it in the verse. You took your time. You were like a true professional, dude. Yeah, there was, you know what was wrong with that performance, guys?
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
You know, man, you did I Believe I Can Fly, you know, and you were all over the place. But this one, you held it back. You milked it, man, and at the very end, it just was beautiful. You did it, man,
you
like you said.
Us,
did it.
You made us. You know what it is? You made us beg. You made us beg for those notes. We were like, give it to us, Jacob. Give it to us, Jacob.
Come on.
You know what it is? You move me. You move us. It's amazing. And that's what you just took your time with it, and you made us beg. It was
and
crazy.
And yo, Jennifer, a shout out to the great bass legend, Mr. Bob Babbitt.
Right.
Yo, great bass legend, dude. Great.
Legend.
Motown legend.
Yeah, yeah.
You moved Steven right up here onto the stage, actually, didn't you? And did he give you a kiss, a hug and a kiss? I hear Grandma's on her feet. She wants the same thing. Nana wants the same thing.
You're doing good. Thank you. I love you.
Good job, Jacob. All right, now I'd like to invite the entire front row to come up and give him a hug and a kiss. Just come on, single file line. No, go ahead. You can come up. Run up. If you want to vote for Jacob, go ahead. 1-866-IDOLS-03. All right, next. Come on up. That's 1-866-436-5703. There you go. Okay, one at a time. And next, go ahead. Or you can text the word vote to 5703. Yeah, go ahead. Plus is online voting at AmericanIdol.com. All right. And here we go. All right. I'm putting you down. I'm gonna have to call it quits. Sir, I'm sorry. We're all out of time, sir. I know it's killing you, but I'm gonna have to stop you there. Thank you very much.
Three.
All right. Three. Well, that's our show for tonight, guys. Thanks for being with us. We'll see you next time. Thanks, Jacob. Appreciate it. It's time for our Southern Belle, Lauren, now. Roll it.
This week, I'm singing the Supremes' 1966 hit, You Keep Me Hanging On. I originally wasn't sure what song to sing for Motown Week, but Rock Mafia suggested You Keep Me Hanging On, and I just fell in love with it.
You picked a great song.
She picked a great song.
and you're not over singing it, but you have a ton of personality.
This song is about a girl who's breaking it off with this guy because he's put her down and she's sick of it. And being in the spotlight, I have people constantly saying things about me that aren't exactly nice. And at first I didn't deal with it well, but now I'm kind of just to the point that I realize I am who I am, and I just have to not let what other people say bring me down all the time.
I was nervous about her about 2 weeks ago. You know, she's stubborn, she was insecure about it, and it was really taking over. When I saw her rehearse this song, she had a lot of confidence and a lot of poise, and she just had a great time with it.
Tonight I want to be really confident with my song choice and just be myself and have a great time.
With You Keep Me Hanging On, ladies and gentlemen, Lauren Elena.
Set me free, why don't you, babe? Get out my life, why don't you, babe? 'Cause you don't really love me, you just keep me hanging on. Yeah.
got it.
No, oh, oh, set me free, why don't you, baby? Get out my life, why don't you, baby? Cause you don't really love me. You just keep me, keep me, keep me hanging on. Yeah.
Well, baby, you ripped that song another beauty mark, didn't you? You know, I don't think you listen to anybody about anything, and I like that about you. Every time you sing, I can hear that person inside that we've been watching grow every time come out a little bit more, and that was just beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You look amazing tonight.
Yeah.
This is the most beautiful I've seen you on the show. It's amazing. You look great. And you know what I loved about this performance? You gave me like, you had like, you threw your head and your neck into it. It was like so much attitude. But you know what? That's what that song required. That's what it needed. And you brought it to life for everybody. It was a really good job.
Thank you.
Yo. So we saw this young girl in Nashville, Tennessee at the end of the day that blew us away in Nashville. Last week, that girl returned to the stage to compete in season 10. Ryan, she's now got her swagger on high, dude. She's ready. She's ready. She's ready, that girl, right? She's ready.
Picking the swagger up. Good job. You feeling better?
Yeah, I feel great.
Excellent. Lauren's numbers, if you like. 1-866-IDOL-04. That's 1-866-436-5704. Or you can text the word vote to 5704. Don't vote until the end of the show. Thank you very much, Swaggeress. After this, we go back to the 80s with a Lionel Richie mega hit. Coming to you from Stefano next.
Jacob did amazing, and that was such a hard act to follow, but I sang that for all the boys out there, so boys, don't mess with me.
Thank you for going with Idol this evening. We are paying tribute to the Motor City tonight as our finalists take on Motown. Give it up for Stefano, ladies and gentlemen. Stefano. I understand that you got a little treat at the mansion.
Oh man, we got a crazy treat. The whole group. My mom actually came by and cooked us the home cooked meal. Where's my mom?
Is she a good cook?
Where's she at? Oh my God, she's insane.
Is this some of the leftovers?
Yeah. You got the leftovers? How'd you get the leftovers? I don't even have any leftovers.
I got pull here, man. So what's the secret?
Oh my God. You know what? She doesn't tell anybody her secrets. It's her thing. So
there's
I ain't got
garlic kicking in that, by the way.
Oh yeah, hey, you gotta watch the garlic. Your breath's gonna stink.
Sorry,
you need a minute. Somebody get him a minute.
We just need you to cook every week, if you don't mind.
Yeah, Ma. That'd be perfect.
You want to sing?
Yeah, let's do it.
I'm on a picnic. All right, take a look at this.
I grew up on Motown, and it was always in the house playing. My parents always had it on. When they told us that we were doing Motown, my first thoughts is, this is great.
So what are you guys doing? We're doing
Hello.
Hello. That's Lionel Richie's Motown days, right?
I never heard the song, and it had been such a huge hit. You know, 1984, it was actually number one on 3 billboards. When I heard it for the first time, I knew that that was a song that I could really connect with and I could really deliver well.
I've been alone with you inside my mind.
You're over-singing some of the parts. You can't start out like you're in the middle of some Broadway play, right? Once you start out, like you're at a your desk and you're writing a letter.
He really wanted me to pull back a little bit, being that this song is so intimate. I needed to let it grow. I needed to let it blossom.
In the last 3 weeks, he has leaped. It's right up there in the top end of his competition. But this week, Stefano chose a very hard song to sing. It's pure emotion.
When you sing this, you want to make sure your eyes are open, because they were closed the whole time.
Yeah.
Looked like you were sleeping for a second. You want to connect with the audience. There's 25 million people watching.
Can't wait to do the song. It will grow, it will connect with the audience, and I will keep my eyes open this time.
David Cook had a huge moment with this song back in season 7, and tonight Stefano tries to do the same. Here he is, eyes open, with Hello.
Kissed your lips 1,000 times.
I sometimes see you pass outside my door. Hello, is it me you're looking for? Tell me how to win your heart, for I haven't got a clue. But let me start by saying I love you, love you, love you, love you. Cause I wonder where you are, and I wonder what you do. Are you somewhere feeling lonely, or is someone loving you? Tell me how to win your heart, for I haven't got a clue. But let me start by saying
talk a little bit, okay? Fine, check, right? Sing like crazy, check. You have that, okay? Now, and you actually shown the audience now that you have that. They may have not known that when we were wild carding you and everything, but now they know that. So now, again, when we're saying open your eyes and do those type of things, it's because we want you to connect. I want you to sing. Jimmy said it right. You're writing a letter. You're telling somebody a story. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't want the intensity to come from you wanting to do well. I want the intensity to come from because your heart is breaking.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And that's what I need from you. And once you do that, you're gonna fly right out of this building, I'm telling you. Amazing. Mm-hmm. But you gotta make that connection.
Yeah.
You hear me?
Yeah, no, Jennifer's right, man, because the only thing you're missing is that connection. You definitely got the pipes, you can sing, I mean, you can soar, and you bit off a big chunk today,
Yeah. And
you had to be perfect emotionally and vocally and pitch-wise and everything to pull off everything you were trying to do.
And sounded beautiful. That was not
Yeah, you sounded good, but it's like there was no real connection. Listen, you can definitely sing. One of the better singers we have here, I think. I mean, you hitting high notes at will, whatever, but there was no real emotion for us in that.
The rhymes and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think,
Stephen? I agree. You ramped up too soon, you know, but your voice is so beautiful. Just got to pull back a little bit, man, and you'll have it.
Even in the phrasing. When you start feeling it from your heart, you watch how your phrasing's going to change as well.
Yeah, take your time.
But you're so... Ugh, I just love you anyway.
So don't kiss me now.
I mean, excellent, excellent advice from Jennifer there.
But listen, Ryan, you can see us all
Randy.
In it because we want him and we know that he is that great, so.
It's an interesting point. How do you get into that headspace when you got a million things
like
going
acting.
On?
It's like acting. You have to like sit there and look at every lyric and think to yourself, who am I singing this to? What am I singing about? Do I feel this? If not, throw it away, next song. You have to connect to it emotionally.
And you can do that. You've been in relationships. I mean, you know, you got to feel
that.
You know what I'm saying? Come on, baby.
You got things going on. You got things going on.
Come on now. You, Ryan.
What? Randy, with all due respect, we're going to cut your mic off at this point. Stefano's number is 1-
You guys have been in relationships.
866-IDOL-05. 1-866-436-5705, or you can text the word vote to 5705. Online voting at AmericanIdol.com, but don't do anything until the end of the show. All right, so you got some coaching there, right?
Got some good coaching. Some good coaching.
Coming up, what Motown song has Haley gone with? Next, live.
Honestly, I felt good about it. I felt like I was hitting all the notes, but honestly, that's not what it takes to be a performer. You have to connect, and I really tried doing that, but it was just a hard song. So hopefully America enjoyed it, and we'll see what happens.
Whoa, Welcome back to our Motown show live this evening. Gordon Ramsay is here. I'm afraid he's going to scream at Stefano's mom for the pasta. What's your opinion?
Thank God he can sing.
Enjoy that, Dustin.
Yes, it's... Yeah, it's fine.
You look afraid of food right now. I've never seen that before. No, hang on, dude. That's yours to keep.
The mom is very unhappy.
I understand. It's a big year for the Supremes and the Temptations as they celebrate 50 years, by the way, of music. And the founding member of the Temps in the house tonight, Otis Williams. Come on, stand up. Good to see you.
Good seeing you as well.
What do you think of the show so far? How's it going?
Fantastic. Everyone is singing from the heart. I love it.
You love it? You enjoying it?
Immensely.
It is a pleasure to have you with us.
Oh, it's a pleasure being here.
Want some penne? up next is Haley. Watch. Haley, you are in the bottom three this evening, all right?
A huge goal this week is to, not be in the bottom three this time. I gotta prove that I really wanna be here. I mean, I do, and I hope that people, while I'm performing, they know that because I'm giving it, 100%.
I don't like you, but I love you.
This week I'm gonna be singing You Really Got a Hold on Me from Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. I love Motown. I've grown up with it my whole life. I've been listening to it on the radio as a youngin', so this is really cool.
You gotta have the confidence and just say, you know what? I got nothing to lose. I'm going for it.
When Jimmy said that, I was like, wow, this really hit home for me.
Okay, let's go for it right now. Hit that first note, right?
Mm-hmm. We worked a bit on her movement, her eye connections, her looking at the camera, looking at the judges. I hope that gives her the confidence just to go out there and really connect, because she's got to connect this week.
You walk with the confidence that you sing, we win. All right.
It's up to you, America, singing You've Really Got a Hold on Me. Here is Haley Reinhardt.
Look, it started a little bit rough. You would look like you were trying to find your way, but I tell you what, by the middle of the song, the Haley that we fell in love with, that we love, that we know, that bluesy with that little growl, with that attitude, came roaring back. And I'm so happy. This is exactly the kind of singer we always thought that you were, with a little Janis Joplin in you. And I'm just happy to see you return to that form, yo. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You feel me, right?
Yeah.
Steven, do you feel me?
I feel you and I felt her. That was beautiful. 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 Touched my heart. You sang your heart out. You don't look a day over fabulous. Beautiful.
I like that. I'm
gonna
use that.
That was really good. That's the Haley I've been looking for since the first time I heard you. And that growl, that growl you got,
do
man, that was
Stevie,
it.
Do it again.
The Joplin thing, man,
Stevie,
that was
do it.
Do
it again. Do it again one more
time. Yeah, yeah.
The same way Steven does that, you have that effortless control in your voice. You know, you can do anything with your voice, probably more than anybody in the competition. It goes where you want it to go. Wherever you're thinking, that's where it goes. And honestly, I think you may have the most soulful voice of anybody in the competition. I mean, I know there's Jacob on the boy's side, but on the girl's side, most definitely.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
And how did you feel doing it?
Yes. I felt great. Yeah.
Good. Well done. For Haley, the number is 1-866-IDOL-06. That is 1-866-436-5706. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5706 from your wireless phone. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Thank you very much,
Thank
Haley.
You.
We appreciate it. Good job. It's a touchy-feely show tonight. It's tangible. We're off to pay the bills, but just around the corner, our country guy, he leaves his comfort zone. Scotty on Motown.